Touting in the Perth studio with us today is Mark Wilson from Legend Mining. Mark, thank you so much for your time today.
My pleasure, Daniel.
As it's your first video, could you please tell the viewers a bit about Legend Mining? What sets you apart? Tell us about the team and the projects, your strategies.
Daniel, it really goes to the basics of investing as far as I'm concerned. It's about the people. We've got a very strong corporate and technical team with capabilities across all of the spectrum that you want for an ASX listed company in 2018. We've got a great project. It's 2,800 square kilometres. I've often described that as the biggest block in the best street. We've got plenty of cash to prosecute any of the programs we wish to. And we've got a tremendously supportive shareholder base in our top 20.
Tell us a little about your shareholders and your management board there.
I'm obviously the managing director and engineer. Our chairman is an accountant with a strong broking background. Our technical director, Derek, is very experienced in exploration in Outback WA and has the gold project of Moolart well on his CV. And last but not least, Tony Walsh, our company secretary, very experienced in all of the regulatory requirements of running a listed company in this day.
And of course, you have Mark Creasy, who's been making news given his legacy in mining in the similar area to yours.
Yeah, Creasy is a very important person. He is our largest shareholder. It's particularly pertinent to know that he paid cash for his shares, so they're not paper that he's got for deals that he's vended into Legend. And that tends to be the profile of the entire top 20. I'm the second largest shareholder. All of my shares have been bought on market. The same goes for basically everyone down the line. But Creasy's history goes back to the 70s when he was chasing the bits that fell out of the sky for Skylab, and he was in his tent in the Fraser Range district and happened to see a result on the bottom of a geological survey map that led him to believe that this area was definitely prospective for nickel copper. And, you know, it's sort of 40 years later when Sirius put the drill hole into Nova, which really woke people up to the fact that this area is probably the most exciting ground for nickel copper exploration, certainly in Western Australia.
And can you tell us a bit about your particular project at Fraser Range? Tell us a bit about the history and the current status, future plans.
Yeah, we acquired this in 2015. It took me the best part of 2 years to negotiate the transaction with Mark. I think it's a wonderful project, and it was really something that we went hard specifically to get. And the reason for that is that this particular part of the Fraser Range is called the Fraser Zone, and it's characterised by three separate gravity anomalies. The southern anomaly hosts the Nova deposit, Legend has the entire central anomaly, and the northern one is basically in a nature reserve, which is very difficult to get permits to explore in. So, you know, we really believe that we are in the sweet central spot of this 18,000 square kilometre area. We've got 3,000 square kilometres of it, so we've got the best part of 18% of the total area.
So that's obviously contributing somewhat to your share price rise. It's gone up by almost 23% today at last look. Can you tell us about the current news that Legend have put out that's accounting for all of this wonderful activity on the stock exchange for you?
Daniel, you know, it's really about this piece of core. And this comes from the Nova mine at, that Independence has. And the significance of that piece of core is that you can mine and produce nickel at $2 a pound, the Australian dollars. The current price is $8.50 or thereabouts. So there's an enormous profit margin in it. And I think an article which one of your journalists, Trevor Hoey, published only yesterday, really in very simple language, understandable language, told investors why the Aircore drilling results that Legend has been releasing over the past 4 or 5 months have got striking similarities to the early days of this Nova deposit in a company called Sirius Resources. And the other interesting aspect is Creasy's position with Sirius is very similar to Legend. He was a 30% joint venture partner. He was a circa 30% shareholder. He did very well out of it. But when you've spent 50 years of your life and, you know, literally $100 million exploring the area, I don't think anybody begrudges Creasy any success that he's had from the region.
Absolutely not. So to wrap up then, you're cashed up. You had a lot of good indicative results back in 2017, and you've got a drill program planned for 2018. Could you please remind us, what are the next key activities for Legend? What are the next key news flows we should be expecting to hear from you, Mark?
Daniel, we're going to keep going with this Aircore program. It's been proven as a good tool for exploration success and price appreciation. That'll certainly occupy most of the current quarter. We then need to follow it up with geophysics in the third quarter. And I would expect off the back of that, we'll end up with a diamond drill program in the last quarter. And that's when it gets really exciting with the discovery potential.
Very exciting indeed. And we do hope to have you back regularly for all of those updates. Mark, thanks so much for joining us from the Perth studio.
Thank you, Danielle.